So that statement was made back in 2018 when the development of this car had not started. And now in 2021, we have the Tata Punch. So as this is going to be a driver focused review, we will deal with the exterior and interior bits later on. Right now, let's get to the driver seat. So before Tata Motors gave this a name, the Punch, it was codenamed X445 and had a provisional title, the Hornbill. The X445 codename actually gives away proof that it is based on the 45X platform, which is nothing but the Altroz. Yes, so that means the Tata Punch is based on the newly developed Alfa Arc platform. The key to this platform is modularity and flexibility to achieve and put different powertrains as well as support an EV architecture. And that is what this Alfa Arc platform is all about. In fact, this platform was the very reason that Tata Motors was able to cut down from its earlier 6 platforms to only 2. One being this, the Alfa Arc platform. The another is the Omega Arc, which actually underpins the Safari and the Harrier. In fact, this Alfa Arc platform is so modular and flexible, it can be compared to the VW's MQB platform. And there was a time around 2017 where VW and Tata Motors were actually in talks in using this Alfa Arc platform, which was previously called the Advanced Modular platform, to use to make vehicles together. Let me conclude by saying that this is the Alfa Arc platform used previously seen in the Altroz, but modified for higher ground clearance and a higher driving position. Coming to the suspension, let me say there are good riding cars in this segment, and the Tata Motors' Punch delivers. So we know that overall the tires also play a good important role. And let me say, though we are riding on 16-inch wheel setup, we are having a decently thick 60 profile tires, and that is really contributing to the overall ride quality being good. As you saw right now, we passed on some rumblers. I did not really slow down too much, but the suspension was there for you to absorb all those bumps. I'm going to pass through another set of rumblers for you to notice in a slow-mo. So yeah, other than riding on right now a decent tarmac, I did drive this car on some bad roads in my area, and I genuinely think it's a great effort, and it's a continuation of the notion that Tata Motors is usually good with ride quality, and that continues here. Coming to the handling and steering, so we know that this is a high riding SUV crossover body style kind of vehicle, but at the same time it's not really too much of a high riding SUV. I believe the ground clearance is just under 190 millimeters, and still that's a decently high ground clearance for taking speed breakers in third gear. So with that kind of ground clearance and this kind of body style, the handling remains playful, and that is the right word, playful. And Another contributing factor for the playful handling is the weight. The punch weighs barely at just above a ton, and that helps it remain nimble. And I would say that the smaller footprint also somehow makes it a good handling car in city-like conditions, and overtaking in smaller city roads or the local highways. It's also important to touch upon the braking system. We get a front disc and the rear hard drum. So this overall braking setup is almost adequate. Also aiding to the braking system is the brake sway control, and this is a segment first feature given by Tata Motors for this segment. The only place where this little Tata lacks a punch is the engine performance. On paper, the specifications are 1.2 liter naturally aspirated. Oh yeah, manual transmission, and approximately 86 horsepower and just 113 newton meters of torque. So that is worrisome, but in real life, the engine feels decently peppy. And when was the last time you get to redline so much on our roads, particularly inside city limits? So that's where, you know, the fun factor of the punch comes in. Another strong reason is that the punch doesn't weigh too much, and that makes it really, well, that makes the engine really peppy enough for the city commute, and decent for highway performance. I personally would have loved a diesel motor in this body style. I really dig diesel engines with manual transmissions. However, it's important to note that this engine has been doing duty in the Tiago as well as the Altroz since a long time, and has been known to be fairly reliable. So that is always a plus point to be known, that this engine has been working since a long time and is a reliable motor. About the gearbox, let me say, I am a supporter of manual gearboxes, and people who have been subscribed to the channel since a long time would be aware. So this will always be my pick from the entire variant offerings for the punch. For anyone who has been in the new age Tata cars would be familiar with this interior. It is having the similar instrument cluster which we've seen previously in the Altroz. The infotainment again is very similar. The overall dashboard layout also is again having the genetics of the new age Tata interiors. The driving position, as I said, has been emphasized to be giving a high driving position SUV experience with increased overall visibility. Also, the infotainment, I believe, is of the right size in my opinion, and it's not unnecessarily large, but it does the job. And it's a system by Harman, which it says very loudly, and so it's a 7-inch system, and I think it comes with the Tata Motors' latest connected car technology, the IRA. The rear seat space is also decently spacious for the segment, and it enjoys a almost flat floor, so that gives out a decent amount of overall legroom for that fifth passenger. So speaking of the fifth passenger, I strongly feel 5 large adults will be a struggle. But yes, 5 normal sized adults can go for a long drive together. So I've had the punch for almost half a day, and the initial impressions seem positive. It is having a small footprint and the practicality of an hatchback. At the same time, it is having the body style, high ground clearance, and a high driving position of an SUV. And that is the right combination needed for the driver to be confident on whatever challenges the Indian roads may offer out there. And on that note, thank you for watching.